Try to pretend that I'd be terrified. Just getting his face. said put him in his place so he could testify.
Differences. Long the Stinky Sweaty Swamp Soiree? The Stinky Sweaty Swamp Soiree. That's the name of our band. I swear to motherfucking God. For reals, yo. Stinky, remember it, it's very easy to remember. Four S's. Stinky, Sweaty, Swamp, Soiree. Yes. On the drums is Shawn Pelton tonight.
Send you love.
musicians who elevate this gig. I send them love. Sound men dealing with my complicated rig. I send them love. Bartenders who get home way too late. Dancers who show us all how to shake. The least I can do is send them love. James Maddock on the guitar, by the way. I don't have that bag with me, but I should. Here it is. And here's another song, yay. Wow. You've been touched by the girl in the front row, James.
It could be worse. just wanna keep pretending we're in love.
Doesn't wanna make me paranoid. A lot of what he says leaves me annoyed.
Give us a breakdown, heckler. Heckler slash sound engineer.
Turn down a little bit, Bob.
Okay. Bob, turn down. Ryan? Manny?
Yeah.
Help us out here. How about Ryan?
Very good. You can come up a little bit.
And I should come up?
You sound perfect. He sounds great. He can come up a little bit. Everybody sounds good.
Okay. You're the nicest heckler I've ever had in my whole life. Right?
Teddy!
Yes, sir.
She wants you to talk to her.
Hello. What can I do for you?
She wants you guys to play Dixie Chicks.
We're going to play a song that's the opposite of Dixie Chicken. This is for you. I wrote this song with a guy named Timothy Speed Levitch. He's kind of a crazy poet guy. Finds out I'm growing, it attacks. Be careful, be cautious. Some masochists made for good kissers, the big fat lips out to immerse you in there. Be careful, be cautious. With that romantic smile is the willful decree of an army to defy. Sometimes self-hate makes for a fun date. You won't know if you're a lover or a baseball bat for a long time after that. Sometimes self-hate makes for a fun date. This love, if you ask me, is good training for a kamikaze. Be careful, be cautious. You thought that self-doubt was something you could tame. You thought that self-doubt was something between you and your insane. Be careful, be cautious. I'm the joyless unworld lady. My life is made of glass and I'm shattered, etc. Sometimes self-hate makes for a fun date. You don't know if you're a lover or a baseball bat for a long time after. Sometimes self-hate training for a kamikaze. Saw Zappa last week. Yeah. She saw Zappa live last week. I don't know how that could be true since the guy's dead, but she saw him. Maybe she saw the younger guy doing his father, whatever. Anyway. Masochism. It's like being in a car chase, only you're in both cars. One of the gunmen is trying to get you. One of the gunmen is trying to save you. Those masochists, they're out there right now, doing it their own way for their own reasons. Out to get themselves by way of getting us. Out to get us by way of taking out themselves. Out to get us by taking out themselves. Out to get themselves by getting us.
yourself neat. Makes for a fun date. You won't know if you're a lover or a baseball bat for a long time after that child. Sometimes self-hate makes for a fun date. This love, if you ask me, is good training for a kamikaze.
That was called Masochists. Yep. Thank you so much. Thanks, Freddie. Thanks for coming, Freddie. Freddie is documenting our show with his video camera. That was yesterday.
Pushy, what's it gonna see? push him away. Watch out, push him, try another day. Watch out, push him away. Watch out, push him, try another day.
Thank you.
Wow, JoJo Mayer on the drums. He's a very talented man. Bob Stander on the bass and dancing. And crying all the same time. Ryan Scott on guitar. James Maddock on guitar. My name's Teddy Kumpel. I'm compelled to say that the Rockwood is great and Danny is great on sound. Thank you, Danny. Kendall is an excellent bartender. Hello, Kendall. Please give her a lot of money after you drink alcohol. Is Shawn Pelton on the drums? You guys want to hear one more quick song? It's going to be really fast, though. Did you really see Zappa?
I did see Zappa at Vibes.
At Vibes?
Gathering the Vibes last summer.
So that was like Dweezil Zappa, right?
You know what? Zappa is great.
I got a Zappa story for you.
But?
I was
tainted. It's another song I wrote with this guy, Speed Levitch.
My favorite co-collaborator.
Thank you so much for coming out, you guys. We are the Stinky, Sweaty... We are the Stinky, Sweaty Swamp Soiree. We'll be back again one day. One day. Danny says it's okay if we play one more if you guys clap it up. We'll get to that. We're gonna do that just for you, Drew. He's hungry. Smells the crumbs from over there. He's gotta get inside. Slicks back his hair. Start. Flies through the air after several tries. He's too tired to care anymore. One last shot. This time he succeeds. He lands right in the slot. He's about to feed. Thank you. think James won the guitar battle. Yes! Champion of the guitar battle.
Thank you, thank you, thank you very much. A pleasure. Thank you.
All the viewers out there who voted for James, we just like to say thank you for watching Guitar Idol. Rockwood Guitar Idol. Manny, you ever have mice in your house? I don't believe you. Is that beard made out of mouse hair?
Yes.
Excellent.
And also,
oh, really? So after the mouse jumped out of my toaster, he took all the crumbs that he found in the toaster and he brought them down behind the stove. He dove down there and brought them down there to his mouse lair.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. I really appreciate you clapping there.
That's where I needed you to clap, man. So he got down there and he took all the crumbs and he stuck them into the mouse IKEA wok that he bought at Mouse IKEA, which is located underneath normal IKEA in Brooklyn. It's where all my mice go shopping for their furniture. You can buy a furniture, you can buy a couch down there with your mouse. Fairly inexpensive. Most mice prefer, hey, I'm trying to talk here, man. I'm trying to tell you a story about Mouse IKEA, man. You don't want to listen? Come on now, you don't know about this mouse. So he was in Mouse IKEA and he bought himself a mouse Gunderstad, which is the best, most comfortable mouse couch there is. Yes, exactly. And he cooked up the crumbs with a mix of other ingredients.
Lincolnberry juice
that he got from IKEA. Mouse IKEA. I don't think they have that, though. They don't like that. Jeez, Drew.
I'm sorry. I'm very excited.
Is that what they're calling it these days?
So he cooked up this concoction. He called it paella, but it was really something else. And he and his mouse friends ate it. He put extra ingredients inside. We think there might have been some acid in there. So all the little mice, after they ate the concoction, were totally tripping, dude. Freddy, you ever do acid?
No. I did acid. It might have been on the news. So I never did. Higher power said do this, but don't.
You got a quarter?
What?
You got a quarter?
I live in quarters.
So he was tripping out with his friends on the mouse acid under the cabinet there. They all had a mouse orgy, a morgy, if you will. They had a morgy.
Together.
Then after they were done, they woke up in the morning. Well, it was like really 2 in the afternoon when they woke up, and they had 75 little mouse babies because the gestation period for mice is very, very quick. The little baby mice climbed out from under the stove, climbed up the side of the kitchen cabinet. They went right back in the motherfucking toaster. Go to teddyjam.com and check it out.
Good night.